Hi, welcome, and thank you for your time. We're going to spend the next few minutes talking about Rocket Cloud Connector, a new product from Rocket Software. When we look at the business of backup and recovery, moving to the cloud and saving backups on the cloud is estimated to save about 50% in your CapEx or OpEx budget, according to Gartner. Doing this also eliminates creating, handling, and transporting of tapes. Ideally, this is all moving to the cloud, although it is possible to also store these backups or these archives in on-prem backup appliances. And then recovery to a DR site when the data is in the cloud is as simple as wherever you choose your DR site to be, connecting to that cloud location and restoring the data. From a storage trend standpoint, Z systems today generate about 70% of all enterprise data. Most backup data is stored on virtual tape libraries or even physical tape still. You can read through most of these stats. The really important one here is the amount of growth in storage, 65% compounded annually, and that 60% of data is never touched 90 days after it's created. So that data is taking up valuable space in those virtual tape libraries. So we'll look at a demo here of Rocket Cloud Connector, or one use case, which is taking backups, making your everyday backups transparent, moving to S3 object storage. We have our normal JCL that we use to backup every day. And then we interface with a product called VTFM-NewGen from Logon Software. This emulates tape drives so that your existing batch jobs can operate as they always have. You're just pointing to a different tape device. When your backup job runs, whether it's backing things up to the cloud or restoring them, we go through the VTFM-NewGen, and then with our Rocket Cloud Connector using TCP/IP connecting to your S3 cloud object storage, maybe that's on Amazon, or an on-prem S3 object storage appliance. So some of the benefits for VTFM-NewGen is that it emulates a tape drive. It looks like a channel-attached tape device. It provides batch job transparency, so there's no changes to your batch job, your JCL, and they're just used as they are today. And at the end, you're writing to cloud or on-prem storage appliance instead of to a more expensive virtual tape device. So the next demo we're going to walk through is doing the backup to cloud object storage, but not using the virtual tape emulator. In this case, we log into our product. This is an ISPF panel for that. And we'll choose an option here to look at our backup history data sets. And we'll see that we have some filters here defined as to what's going to be backed up and the cloud name or the destination of where that's going to go, whether it's an appliance or to a cloud destination. And you can have different data set patterns going to different destinations. When you submit that behind the scenes, we're taking that information and we're connecting to our task running on the mainframe. And it looks much like it did before, except that the tape emulator isn't there. And so now you're writing through us, right? We're picking up those data sets and we're writing it directly out to whatever that destination was, whether it's S3 cloud object storage or the on-prem storage. Another use case is to recover from cloud object storage. It's great to be able to write out there, but you also need to retrieve that data sometimes. In this case, we'll look at our cloud data sets. So we want to look at what data sets are stored in the cloud or in that S3 object storage appliance. And so we'll look at everything and we get a list of all of the data sets, when it was backed up. You see the name that it is on your system, as well as the name we gave it in the cloud. And we'll select which of those we want to recover. And then behind the scenes, we again take action on that and through our product, read those data sets back from the cloud and restore them back onto the mainframe. It really is that simple, and we're happy to talk to you about it, and I thank you for your time.